second part of this tutorial will demonstrate how to create new map objects and attribute the objects with the correct pattern fill and text attribute. For this example, we need to open up a base layer which we can digitize from. In this instance, it's the Cloncurry geological map sheet. To demonstrate how to use Picklist whilst digitizing, we'll need to navigate to the Discover tab. Under the Data Entry Toolkit group, go to the Apply drop-down, and now we're going to use the Apply Style tool. Once again, we get a representation of the pick lists within this dialog, and the same as the Apply Pick List dialog, this is purely in a read-only pattern. So let's navigate to the Eyes of Geological pick list. We're going to use this as the basis for digitizing. Now, what we're going to do is update these particular units here. So it's the PGU units. Now, I know they are the Naraku granites. So what I need to do to use the Apply Style dialog, as I've done previously, choose the pick list. Now select the code. And what we need to do also is we want to insert that code into a table. And in this instance, it's going to be the ISA geology table. So on the second portion of the style dialog, go to the style description options. Check that box there, so the insert style description. So what this will do, it will insert that Naraku granite code into the selected table, so ISA geology, and we want to put it into the unit name column. So all we need to do now is click apply. What that apply will do, will set the style within map info. So if we navigate to the Map Info Spatial tab and the style, you'll see now that the region style pattern has adopted the Naraku granite style. So all we need to do now is use the tools available within Map Info Pro to start digitizing. In this instance, we go to the Spatial tab, the Create group, and the Insert drop-down. I want to start digitizing some polygons. To make things a little bit easier, let's zoom in. To now validate if the correct code has been inserted into the table, what I will do is turn on the labels. As you can see here, the colours of that orange is for the Naraku granite, and we can see the text labels are corresponding to the Naraku granite. So using pick lists in this way is an efficient and easy way of applying your standard styles. For the next example, I will show you how the Apply Style dialog can also be used to select objects and apply the selected code or pick list style. For this example, what I'm going to do is this particular unit here, I'll accidentally digitize with the Naraku granite. Okay, so that has been incorrectly digitized. So what I'm going to do now is go to the quaternary, and now I want to select that particular unit, click apply, and that has changed it to the quaternary. So as you can see here, we can use the apply style for firstly digitizing and subsequently selecting an object and updating. This concludes the apply picklist tutorial. Thank you for watching.